Today in our 2012 Honda Cross Tour, we'll be having a look at our best trailer hitch options. All right, we have two hitches here today. On the top, we have the Drawtite, part number 24852. And on the bottom, we have the Curt, part number C11002. Now, one of the biggest differences we found between our two hitches here today is when it comes to appearance. We found that the Curt hitch here looks the best of our two hitches when it's installed on our vehicle. And one of the reasons for this is that the frame of the hitch here, being a round tubular design, really contours well to the curve on a rear fascia. Now, the Drawtite hitch has this plate that's welded on the top of the frame of the hitch and the receiver itself. You can see how the plate sticks out well past the fascia, and there's this large gap in between the hitch and the fascia itself, and that takes away from the clean looks of the Cross Tour, I believe. Now, the Drawtite hitch, you'll notice this gap is fairly large, and the hitch actually sticks out pretty far past the fascia. Our Curt hitch, however, is much more tucked up tight to the fascia and doesn't stick out near as far, and not having this plate right here makes it look a lot more like a factory hitch would on the vehicle. On our Curt hitch here, this welded on collar, which adds reinforcement to the receiver of our hitch, also gives it a nice clean look and helps make the end of it look a lot better. If we look up at the Drawtite hitch, you can see how without the collar, it's just like a piece of angled steel is just cut flush off and then powder coated. It doesn't give us that nice clean look that we're looking for. Now, recreationally speaking, we found a difference with the Curt hitch here requiring a stabilization strap to help support the load for non-trailer applications, such as with bike racks and cargo carriers. Our Drawtite hitch, however, doesn't require the use of that stabilization strap, so it makes it more of an ideal hitch to use with a bike rack or a cargo carrier, which is what most of the Cross Tour customers we found are using this hitch for. One of the final differences that we found between our two hitches is when it comes down to towing, we found that the Curt hitch here would actually be easier for us to use when we're towing a trailer. Part of the reason for this is because our safety chain plates here are easily accessible, and our hitch pin hole here only really covers up the back part of our safety chain loop opening right here. If we look up at our Drawtite hitch though, the plate here makes it more of a hindrance to insert your pin and clip to secure your ball mount. Also, the hole for your pin and clip is right in the middle of your safety chain loops. So if you have a locking device to secure your ball mount, you will find it difficult to insert your safety chains into place. Now, as far as similarities go, both of these hitches feature the exact same weight capacities. They are both class 1 hitches with a 200-pound max tongue weight rating and a 2,000-pound max gross trailer weight rating. Obviously, when you're towing a trailer with your Cross Tour, you want to consult with the owner's manual of your vehicle and not exceed what the vehicle is capable of or what the hitch is capable of. You don't want to cause damage to either one. Now, as far as installation goes, we found both of these hitches to be very similar here. They both install into the exact same locations on the vehicle. You don't need any special tools at all in order to install either one of these. Now for a brief summary. We found when it came down to appearance that the Curt hitch was a clear winner here because it does look better on the vehicle than the Drawtite hitch does. As far as recreational use goes, we found the Drawtite hitch to be a superior hitch here because we don't need to use that stabilization strap that the Curt requires in order to help support the loads. And finally, as far as towing goes, we found the Curt hitch here to be the clear winner because of the ease of use in order to secure your ball mount and hook your safety chains from your trailer on up to the hitch. And that completes our look at the best trailer hitch options for the Honda Cross Tour.
Click the link below to shop, learn more, or visit us at eTrailer.com.